Thank you for watching, and in this video we are going deep through the specifications of hole wizard. In my feature tree, as you can see, I have 5 counterbore holes. So what I want to do is I can just select this feature and I want to edit this feature. And into this feature, we already discussed in the last videos, we have all these hole types. So if you want to switch between the hole types, so what you can do is right now, as we are in the counterbore, so if you want to go into the countersunk, so you can just click on that and you can see the style of the holes is gonna be changed. And under the styles, you can see there is standard, like you can choose whatever the standard you want to have. Right now these holes are made by using ANSI inch, so if you want to change, if I'm gonna go into DIN, so you can see the type of slots or holes that are also dependent on the standard and even the sizes as well. So if you are in metric, so all the options you are gonna see is all the styles or types which are available into metric and the sizes as well. As you can see, we have M1, M2, M3, 5, 6. So because right now we are into the standard of ANSI metric. Okay, I'm gonna go back into the counterbore. And then there is another option, like if you don't want to use these industry standards and you want to have your own hole size or whatever you want, so you can just click the show custom sizing. And then you can just select the head size and depth and at which angle you want to have and these kind of things. But I would not recommend to go with the custom sizes, because in the future then you can face some kind of problems. Okay, and down here you can see in the another options, like you can have head clearance or you can see near side countersunk. So if you are into the counterbore and if you want to have a head clearance, then it's gonna be asked at what size you want to have your head clearance. So in this way you can choose whatever you want, and then after these specifications, when you are satisfied with them, so what you can do is you can go into the positions. And then into the positions, as you can see, wherever you are gonna click, the hole is gonna be made there. And if you want to have some kind of sketch, so what you can do is you are ready into the sketch, so you can just draw your sketch. And right now, like, this command is on, so what I can do is I can just press the escape key, or I can just uncheck this point. So the command is off now. And suppose I want to have a center rectangle here, so what I can do is I can just select the center rectangle and I can start make a center rectangle like this. And then I can just select it here into the feature manager, into options. I want to made it just for construction, so I'm just gonna check for construction, and then I'm gonna click the green check mark. And then after that, you can see like this is converted into the construction, and now I already have holes. So what I want to do is I just want to move these holes onto the corners of this center rectangle. So I'm just gonna pick this point and then I'm gonna bring it to the corner of the rectangle like that. And if you want to bring this as well on corner or into the midpoint, so you can just bring them. And I would like to bring it as well. Let's bring this as well, and I want to have this as well. And let's say I want to bring this one as well into the center. And if you still want to have more holes, what you can do is you can just check this point and you can just click this point command, and then you can just draw holes wherever you want to draw into the midpoint. Okay, and then when you are done, you can just press the escape key. And then if you are okay with your sketch and holes, then you can just click the green check mark. Look, in this way, all the holes according to your specifications you can found on your part. And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious Solidworks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.